Hello, everybody, and welcome to the first episode of the 2020 player season review. So if you've watched this channel from the beginning, you'll know that at the start of every year, every single player has a preview for the upcoming season, and likewise at the end of the year. So we're going to do this in order of player numbers, and let's start with number one, Jack Silvani. Really disappointing year, not of any fault of his own. It was just one of those years where injury ravaged him, and unfortunately, we didn't get to see him carry on with what we did see from him at the end of 2019. I thought he really started to cement himself in that 22 towards the end of the year. He seemed to add that layer of strength where he just wasn't able to be taken to ground. It looked like he was primed for a pretty good 2020. And, you know, he ends up playing only the three games. And it's hard to really get a gauge on his season and if he developed and whatnot, because it never happened for him. You know, there was obviously the shot that he took from Zach Merritt, which had him out for a week or so. And then he had some issues with his ITB. And you know, really, it was just disappointing. And this is a guy who I think is very important to us, and he's someone who probably has flown a little under the radar because he sort of cemented himself in the team at the end of 2019, and we've now had a full season pretty much without him. But I still think there is a very important role for him to play. And I mean, it's ironic that I'm saying this, but he seems like, because he's so versatile, if we end up missing someone like a Charlie Curnow or a Harry Mackay or a Mitch McGovern, he can play that third tall, because that's obviously what we're looking to do with David T. That's what he enjoys doing. So he can play that role. He can also play a little small because he's got that mobility. He's creative. But really, it was hard. It was hard to really give any sort of insight into his season. If there's probably one thing I realized this year about Jack Silvani, it's how much I feel like we need him in the side. We did miss his pressure and his crafty ways with ball in hand. He did kick a few goals in round one against Richmond, but seems like a lifetime ago. So, I mean, look, it's an NA for me. I can't really give him a rating. I can't give you any insight into the player ratings that he had this year. But, you know, for Jack, it's all about getting healthy for a big preseason and looking ahead to 2021. And that's really what it's all about. It's important that we get him back into the side. It's important that he, you know, starts to really fulfill that potential, which we started to see. And then we move forward from there. So a short one here, but we're doing the full list here. So what about you guys? What did you learn about Jack Silvani in 2020? Did you feel the same as me? Did you feel like we definitely missed him? Do you think he definitely has a spot in the side come next season? Where does he play? How do we put him into the side? I've seen some suggestions that he could maybe even push into the midfield a little bit. Do you feel that way? Let me know and let's chat about it.